This is setup of the Tapo C420S2. There's a lot of stuff on the table here. Like the Ethernet cable is connected to a Wi-Fi modem over there because the hub right here needs to be powered on and connected to Ethernet in order to connect itself to the camera itself. I have it sitting on one of the pods right now. The other thing is, the batteries for the camera do not come fully charged, so you will need to charge these before you can actually get things started. First, charge your battery, get your connection points together, and that puts it in place. Now, there is a reset and sync button in here, so we're actually going to just gently place the back right there. Actually, we'll just let it fall off. And then we are going to open the Tapo app and press the plus sign in the upper right-hand corner. And then we're going to figure out which camera we are setting up. And right here is the C420. In our case, the S2 indicates that we got the bundle package. So we're gonna select that. Right here, we need to set the hub up. So we're gonna say hub. We have not added this to power or the Wi-Fi yet. So that's what we're gonna do. First things first, we're gonna connect it to Ethernet. This way we get things started right away. Also, I do have a micro SD card in the back there already. And then we're just going to take our power cable and place it in the back. Now, right now it is showing red right there. And we are supposed to wait until it flashes amber according to the application. So we'll give that a moment to do what it needs to do in order to start flashing amber. And just as I've learned in the past with other hub devices like this, can't use mesh networking, has to be attached to the actual main hub. So we're gonna go do that. Once you properly connect the Tapo hub, it starts flashing amber, and then you see the screen that says looking for a device. So it found it. This is the screen that came up. It wants me to name it. I select next. I'm gonna leave it at that name. Where is this device placed? Well, it says garage. It's not in the garage. I'll say it's in the living room. Next, and we can pick an icon for it. I'm gonna leave it as a thing that looks like the Tapo hub. And now it's configuring. There is a firmware that needs to be updated for it. So we're gonna allow that to happen. Once firmware is up to date, you'll get this screen so we can pair another device, or done for now. Well, we need to actually pair our camera. So we're going to select pair another device, and these are the cameras that we can add. Now, I took the battery out the back here, but if I tap it in, it will start flashing red and green, letting us know that it's in place. Now, the battery doesn't slide as much as I thought it would, so that's good. We are going to select our Tapo C420, and it's letting us know, unscrew, put the battery in. Oh, and then it wants us to lock it back up. So battery's in there. I guess we're not going to have to press the sync button. So we're just going to lock that in place. So it is now locked. We will select next. We see that it is flashing, so it's already flashing. So right now it is describing the MAC address for this, and how do I find the MAC address? So I'm going to select that. Yes, this is the MAC address, and it is going to try and pair this camera with the base station. Now the base station is downstairs, so I'm curious to see how well this will actually connect. But one would hope, if it's going to be outside and talking to the base station, that this is no problem. All right, there we go. It connected, and I'm just going to call this. Oh, yep, there's the Alex A command. Where is this going to be? Garage, living room, or custom? We'll say custom, and it's gonna be in my backyard, and then we can pick a picture for it. In this case, I'm just gonna do the icon and select next, and congratulations, we're all done. So we can add another device, select next, or done. I'm going to select next, see what happens. All right, so we've got the option for a Tapo Care 30-day free trial. We are going to skip that for the time being. And it's letting us know we can always go back and do it if we want. I'm gonna say got it. Next, it says load up the SD card, which we already did. It does take up to a 256 gig card, which is great because this set has two cameras. We're gonna say got it. Now we can done for now or mount the wall. And if we mount the wall, it's gonna walk us through the directions about how to do this. So fully charge everything, placement, test the Wi-Fi signal, which is going to give us a live feed from that. Once it connects, there you go. So we're just gonna say next, talking about optional placements for that. And I'm just gonna say, yep, it's on a table because that's where it is. We have the ability to invert an image if we wanted to. So here it is talking to the camera again. I'm just gonna say this angle is good so we don't have to wait through this, and select finish. And there we go. And we will select back. And that completes the setup of both the hub and the Tapo C420.